Up for the Fight: How to Advocate for Yourself as You Battle Cancer from a 5-time Survivor. Written and narrated by Bill C. Potts, with additional narration provided by my wife, Kim Potts, son, Nick Potts, and daughter, Anna Potts. Dedication: To my amazing family, who has supported me throughout this long and continuing journey. My soulmate and wife, Kim, has been my rock and support. My 3 kids, Nick, Sarah, and Anna, have been incredible. Their hugs, popsicles, calls, and visits mean the world to me. My sweet dog, Pippa, has been by my side nonstop. She's a great listener. To my mom, Barbara, who taught me how to fight by winning her own brutal battle with cancer. To my late dad, Tom Potts, who always encouraged his kids to write and inspired me with his own cancer fight. To the thousands of brave, tough kids and adults I met at Clearwater Marine Aquarium, the people in wheelchairs, those with prosthetic limbs, the wounded warriors, the cancer patients, and all those who are up for the fight in the face of adversity, you inspire me. And to the millions of cancer patients and their families fighting their battles, and to all the healthcare professionals fighting valiantly for them. Epigraph: Own your cancer journey. Your life depends on it.
Foreword by Elizabeth Sorensen, advanced practice nurse at MD Anderson Cancer Center. It has been over 10 years since I first met Bill in the lymphoma clinic at MD Anderson Cancer Center. I was the advanced practice nurse on Bill's cancer care team and worked closely with Dr. Nathan Fowler, a specialist in the lymphoma clinic. Bill had an interesting story. He'd been previously diagnosed with thyroid cancer, and his biopsy was showing a new primary, also known as a completely different kind of cancer. This new cancer might have been mistreated had he not advocated so well for himself. Bill appeared cool, calm, and collected that day, though I can only imagine what he must have been feeling and experiencing beneath the surface. He shared his cancer story, which is such an important part of the initial visit. Together, we came up with a plan. We also established a patient-nurse relationship based on sharing, listening, and supporting, which has turned into a friendship that I'm grateful to have. Bill followed the plan that Dr. Fowler set for him. One unforgettable day, we were able to tell him, "You're in a remission. No cancer was seen on the scans." What many people don't realize is that the hardest part of having cancer often starts once the treatment and constant clinic visits end. When the healthcare team has been holding your hand throughout the treatment, it can feel like they're letting go and leaving you to face the journey ahead on your own. Bill was great about staying in touch and keeping us informed about his recovery and healing. He shared with us that he wanted to complete Ironman Texas after he went into remission. Not only did he stay in touch with us, he invited Dr. Fowler and me to meet him at the Ironman finish line. It was over 100 degrees in Houston that day, and many athletes were struggling on the course. But Bill made it to the finish line and gave us a big old hug as he crossed. I told him, "You're amazing. Now I have to do a triathlon." Right at that moment, race day caught up with him and he got wobbly. His knees started to shake and someone scooped him up with a wheelchair and ran him to the medical tent where he recovered with IV fluids. I was hoping he'd forget what I said. But no, he called me the next day and said, "Liz, I'll never forget what you said." The point is, Bill is an incredibly inspiring human, and he made an impression on me from the very first day. I went on to complete 7 triathlons while raising money for the Leukemia and Lymphoma Society. Bill managed his cancer journey with vulnerability, wholeheartedness, courage, and faith. He's recorded this book using these same qualities, and he's used his gifts of inspiration and discipline to outline all the most important points to help many people along their journey. I hope you are as inspired by Bill as I have been, and I wish you well on your journey.
Introduction. On September 17th, 2020, I woke up sobbing in the recovery room at the Mayo Clinic in Jacksonville, Florida. I had just gone through surgery to remove a painful and cancerous tumor from my groin area. I had gone into the surgery scared, but stoic and confident. I had awoken to an emotional breakdown. As the tears flowed, Jen Green, The nurse sitting by my side reached down, held my hand, and asked me, "Bill, what is wrong?" The words that came out of my mouth astonished both of us. "Jen, I'm thinking about giving up the cancer fight. Maybe it is time to throw in the towel." Then I told her my story. "This is the sixth time I've been diagnosed with cancer and my fifth cancer surgery. This is the fourth time I've had lymphoma after only 11 months in remission. 2 months ago, I was diagnosed with prostate cancer too. So now I have two cancers at the same time, and my type of lymphoma is incurable and will come back. This is on top of the thyroid cancer I had 20 years ago. I've had a very fulfilling life since my initial cancer diagnosis. My cancer has driven me to try and accomplish a lot as fast as I could. It changed my priorities. I have helped raise three awesome kids, am in an amazing marriage, I've had a successful career in marketing, I've worked at Ironman, am an Ironman athlete, have run marathons, and have even run up the Empire State Building. I spent the past 4+ years in a job I loved at Clearwater Marine Aquarium, a job with a deep purpose where I was able to meet thousands of kids and adults with physical and emotional challenges. I watched them be inspired and changed just by meeting Winter the Dolphin. I was BFFs with Hope the Dolphin, with whom I played hide and seek each morning. The people who I met were inspired in turn by the care and love of the amazing aquarium team who rescued, rehabilitated, and released marine life. Each day at the aquarium, I had the opportunity to help change lives, and I was proud of the work I did there. I worked to prove to my family that anything is possible, that no matter what happens to you, with hard work, a positive attitude, and a great support team, big goals can be accomplished. But I finally paused to take a breath. I know what is coming with the cancer treatment, and I don't like it. Jen called the Mayo pastor, Tanya, who had been with me just prior to the surgery. Tanya listened as I told my story. I started asking her questions about why she worked at Mayo Clinic with patients like me. Her powerful answers helped me reconnect with my why I needed to fight cancer again and beat it, for my family and friends, to inspire others, for the nonprofit clients at my marketing agency, to make God proud. An hour after my meltdown began, I reconnected with my purpose. I was ready and up for the fight. I believe that miracles happen, and my change of heart was itself a miracle. Tanya wrapped up our chat with the following comment. "Bill, your story is unique. You should write a book and share with others what you have learned through your journey. Use your pain for the purpose of helping others." This is that book. Cancer, to quote author John Green, is a civil war. Cancer is a part of me, a bad part. It is trying to kill the good part of me. So it is the good me fighting the bad me, thus battling cancer, a civil war. Let's be upfront. I hate cancer. I am not a doctor, but a cancer veteran, a survivor. You have to be a survivor in order to really understand how to battle cancer. For example, I am an avid runner. What is some of the best advice I have given runners doing their first 5K? Double knot your shoelaces. This is insight which can only be provided by someone who has experienced their shoelaces coming untied in a race. This book is like that insight, but for cancer. Up for the Fight is Cancer Uncut, the real story. While writing this book, I went through 14 chemotherapy and immunotherapy treatments for my lymphoma, a blood cancer, as well as multiple surgeries, 2 minor, 1 major. I had a surgical biopsy of my prostate related to my prostate cancer. I wrote while grinding through physical and emotional pain. It was not easy. There were days and weeks when I was too sick to write. Reliving what I had been through, was going through, was painful. But this book has provided me great purpose, a reason to get up, head to our garage apartment, write, and share what I learned. I wrote it while in relative isolation, in a bubble, as the beatdown of my immune system from chemotherapy and the risk of getting COVID-19 or a flu or cold prevented me from being around many people. I know the cancer issues. I've been through the journey, a lot. 5 times surviving, 6 in progress, 7 likely just a few years away. If you have been diagnosed with cancer, you are in the cancer club, Like being a marathoner or an Ironman, you will always be in that club. Your family and friends will be in this club too. As a longtime member of the Cancer Club, I have learned how to advocate for myself. I am 100% certain that had I not advocated for myself, I would not be alive to write this book. The biggest problem I've had during my 20-year cancer journey? Learning from trial and error what works, every step of the way. There was no guide on what to expect, physically, mentally, emotionally. I wish I had read a book like this at the start of my journey, but none existed. I have been surprised 1,000 times with head-spinning stuff. Just having some idea of what to expect would have made a positive difference for me and my family. This book is not a critique of the current medical system. Modern medicine has saved me 5 times so far, and I have been fortunate to be treated at 2 of the best cancer clinics in the U.S., MD Anderson Cancer Center in Houston and the Mayo Clinic, Jacksonville campus. What this book will do is guide you through the cancer journey, from first steps when getting the news to tests you may get to stage it, what types of treatment to expect, and how to ace your treatment days, manage side effects, and anticipate the unexpected. I've also included tips on dealing with the mental and emotional side of the journey, which can be as hard or harder than the treatment itself. If you listen to only 2 chapters, please listen to chapters 4 and 5. They will offer suggestions on how to work within the medical system, advocating for yourself on your own cancer journey, as well as how to pick a care team. In my favorite chapter, chapter 14, you will hear from my family about their tips for family members on the journey, followed by advice for the friends of cancer patients. Chapter 7, on the business of cancer, offers practical insights on your options for fighting cancer. I also address the possibility of dying in chapter 13 and offer insight on how cancer impacts you after the treatment is finished, chapter 15. I know it's hard to fathom, but going through the cancer journey may change your life and the lives of those around you in a positive way. If you are listening to this book, you or someone you know has been given the tough news. You are in the cancer club. Remember, you are not alone. There are not only millions of others in your same situation, but many people and organizations will support you along the way. I wrote this book with 2 simple goals. 1, to help you learn from my mistakes. 2, to tell you what most doctors can't tell you about fighting cancer from the perspective of the cancer patient. Some of my favorite motivational lessons? Remind yourself every day of the reasons you are fighting. Every day. This is a great motivational tool. Run your cancer journey like it is a race. Break it into small goals. Celebrate these goals along the way until you finish. Celebrate each step of the journey. First treatment, booyah. Halfway through the treatment, booyah. Finish treatment, ring the bell. Celebrate birthdays, anniversaries, and other occasions that happen during your journey with gusto. Celebrate accomplishments of your friends and family during your journey with gusto. Tell your family and friends you love them. Chapter 1, The Tough News. As of the writing of this book, I have been in the cancer club for 20 years. I have been told I have cancer 7 times. 1 diagnosis was wrong, but 6, unfortunately, were right. My journey started when I was 41 years old in 2002. I was diagnosed with thyroid cancer. The news came out of nowhere. I was totally unprepared for what lay ahead. At the time, I had been married 10 years to my wife, Kim, and the father of 4-year-old twin girls, Sarah and Anna, and a 7-year-old son, Nick. The thyroid cancer was cured, but I received the bad news again in 2003. Incorrectly, a return of the thyroid cancer, 2008, lymphoma, 2014, lymphoma, 2019, lymphoma, and 2020, lymphoma plus prostate cancer. My lymphoma is incurable, and we are already planning how to handle it when it comes back. Starting the fight. I had just come back from completing Ironman 70.3 Cancun in 2008 when I noticed a lump below my right ear. Given my scare with thyroid cancer, I immediately went to my primary care physician, who referred me to an ear, nose, and throat doctor. This doctor conducted surgery to remove what at the time was thought to be a harmless infected parotid.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.